Art which is being addressed and quoted here is art of Soviet Cultural Revolution of late 20s, early 30s, the most radical anti-capitalist phase of Soviet art and economy, called Stalin's leftist zigzag, when he temporarily adopted some of the most radical ideas of Trotsky since 27, already in exile. It is this largely unknown art of cultural revolution and industrialization period, which 10 years after the revolution, and with the feeling of its irrevocability, at its most radical phase in 1930-31, this art rejected early avant-garde geometrical forms and constructivist style, already routine and commercialized, and concentrated on photography, film, and illustrated mass magazines, theater performance. So this, for example, is a 6 meters long stage design, so to speak, for public political discussion, and revolutionary reenactment, as well as critical sculptures, so to speak. So this is British imperialism. Since the notion of artwork as an autonomous object was drastically questioned, many of these artifacts were only rarely and accidentally preserved in museums, in the originals or at all. And of course, here is Alexander Rodchenko, early Anton Lavinsky's portrait, where the protagonist literally turns his back to a nude photograph, which stands here for the old art with its classical nudes, and more precisely, bourgeois art with its notion of a painting as a prostitute. Communist artistic production aspired to eradicate not just the division of labor, but the subject-object opposition inscribed in it, as well as in gender relation. And last but not least, in traditional representation, in the relation of a male artist with his model or nature or reality. Like in contemporary participatory practices, the social interaction of artists with the project spectators slash participants was more relevant than the artwork itself, its materiality, and even more so, its so-called quality, a criterion imposed by the bourgeois market. The deprofessionalization of art was programmatic, as it was its merging with industrial production and working class, with whom artists intended to work together in a brigade, a team, or at least to model an artistic brigade after workers' collectives. So here the cover of a magazine, Brigade of Artists. Here's an artwork of the Futemas Brigade of students, and executed collectively and anonymously, and the topic, pay attention that Lenin is not alone on the top. The topic itself addresses this programmatic democratic collectivity. And also, Pavel Filonov's collective, which was called Masters of Analytical Art, and this work is called Shop Workers, but it definitely addresses and depicts artists, members of his collective. The point of these associations and the meetings they held was discussion among themselves and with the new audience for art. Instead of consuming art in the mode of real or symbolic possession, they proclaimed a new mode of working with art via discursive practice and self-criticism. Wrote on it, for comparison. And indeed, it was this comparison with bourgeois art in the first place, Soviet artists were inscribing themselves, often refusing to be pleasurable or entertaining in their production. Soviet art, often anonymous and collectively produced, collectively perceived, and almost always a copy and not an original, was a programmatic challenge of all the assumptions of bourgeois artwork. It is not likable and not intends to be. Pioneers of Commune is an obvious reference to early icons and frescoes. We would treat it's a small bit. So narrative realism was understood as a kind of foresight of the future ideal. The term in Soviet aesthetics was anticipation, a dialectical representation of things, not as they are, but as they want to be. The depiction of reality as is was also, from this point of view, a kind of formalism, a dogmatic adherence to the canon, an ability to see and capture reality in its development, in its becoming. And here is the most programmatic work of late Malevich of 35, A Working Woman. I would compare it first to an extremely modest and unambitious realist work by a minor artist, Yefim Chevtsov, known for The Gesture, where it's called Meeting of the Village Committee of the Communist Parties, that small. an idea of the thing, of the new woman, as well as of the new painting, dependent on the discussion. I'm not a commodity, it says, to the same extent Olympia was saying the opposite. Her body is flat, like early suprematist painting, but her face and hands are disturbingly realistic, as if this realism were suddenly re-emerging in a scandalous Olympia-like way. Not just a woman, but the painting itself is here a person, an engaged subject, and the public speaker. As I already stated, we are now in a situation where artists turn their back.